Good afternoon. My name is Thomas Bell. I'm Director of Music at St. James Cathedral, and it is a great pleasure to welcome you both in person and online to what's going to be a wonderful organ recital. We're delighted to welcome Brad Barbeau, who is the Interim Director of Music at St. George's Kingston, and he's going to fortuitously and thoughtfully present a program of music suitable for St. George's Day, which I believe was last Saturday, if I've got my dates correct. Brad is a wonderful, fantastic musician, brings much to St. George's as a church musician, and is a dear colleague as well. So Brad, thank you in advance for your time, your music, and all you will bring to us, your gifts this afternoon. So thank you. Brad will say a few words about the program to introduce it.
Thank you, Tom. And thank you to St. James for having me today. It's quite an honor to be here. I have a little story, actually, that I wanted to give you to begin with. I must have been about 10 or 12, and I was taken by some parishioners of the church I attended in Madoc at the time to, I don't remember the name of it, to a church in Campbellford, where Giles Bryant had his, vacation home, if you will. And Giles was giving a recital at this small parish church, and I was taken there to see this recital, and bear in mind, this was 30-odd years ago. I didn't know who Giles was at the time and didn't know any of these other things as well, so I show up there and was duly introduced to the great man at the end of the recital, and Giles very graciously invited me to come here and try the organ, and said that he as a boy had been invited to do such a thing, and it never actually happened, but it's still something that stuck with me to this day. And Giles and I are very good friends, and I really appreciated that gesture when I was 10 or so. The music that I selected today are all things by English composers. The Tallis theme by Vaughan Williams, it's a shortened version of a much longer orchestral work. George Thalben Ball's Elegy was actually based on an improvisation he did for the BBC and then later wrote down as it is now. Most of us, I think, will be familiar with Nimrod from Elgar's Enigma Variations. The next piece, the Rondeau from Abdelezar, probably is not familiar to people by that name. Most of you might recognize it as Britain's Young Person's Guide to the Orchestra, but he got it from Purcell. I'm including Willan as an English person here today, but if I was giving a Canadian recital tomorrow, I'd count him there too. It suits my case to put him here today. So he has a beautiful little set of pieces called Matins and Evensong. Nothing about English church music is complete without mentioning Sir Charles Villiers Stanford, of course. He has a number of smaller pieces. This is a fairly short piece based on an Irish melody, one of the alternate tunes to the inner verse to St. Patrick's Breastplate, actually. The little Prelude in G by Sir William Harris is a favorite of Her Majesty the Queen's. It's been done at a number of royal events. It's quite short, very beautiful. And if you don't know, Sir William Harris was, if you will, the Queen's music teacher at Windsor. He was at Windsor Chapel for quite a long time, and I believe during the war years when they were hiding in Windsor, and he was their private music teacher. And the final piece, a more contemporary, if you will, selection by by Howells, called Master Tallis's Testament. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Brad, thank you so much for your time and impeccable musicianship and all you brought to giving us such a lovely 40 minutes of music. It's most appreciated. Thank you for joining us. Our next concert is on May the 10th. When we look forward to seeing you once again, we wish you all our very best wishes and look forward to seeing you again. Thank you very much.